Greetings, this is Alaya from the star system of the Pleiades. There is a spiritual transformation occurring on Earth because higher energies of the existence are channeled to the planet to lift the planet into a higher level of evolution. Individuals who are touched by these higher energies of love want to assist the planet in this process. Since 12 years, I traveled with many of those loving people to power spots on Earth to channel higher vibrations of love and clean the Earth from negative energies. In November 2011, I traveled with 10 loving people to the island of Bimini in the Bermuda Triangle. Bimini was a part of Atlantis, and close to it was the most powerful energy center of Atlantis. It was the vortex of Atlantis. Before I show you our journey there, let me tell you the history of Atlantis and the civilizations before Atlantis, because the Earth civilization of today has a similar behavior. In the past 10 million years on Earth, 8 technically advanced civilizations have destroyed themselves at the end because they abused technology and power and did not live spiritually. There were civilizations of humanoid and non-humanoid astronauts who came from other parts of the universe. Their weapons were 1,000 times more destructive than what the Earth people have today because they abused cosmic energy. This is not fiction, this is the sad true history of Earth. Their wars produced a strong radioactivity which have mutated creatures. That is how the dinosaurs came, who were later killed by other astronauts to rebuild a new civilization. This civilization abused weapons too, and destroyed the planet who used to be between Mars and Jupiter. Today's asteroid belt there is what is left from that destroyed planet. Approximately 1 million years ago, other space travelers came and colonized the Earth. They built the civilizations of Lemuria and Atlantis. The Earth back then looked different than today. Lemuria was a continent in the Pacific Ocean. Atlantis was a continent in the Atlantic Ocean. Atlantis was more advanced than today's Earth humans, and they were using giant crystals with strong cosmic energy. Their lifespans could reach up to 1,000 years. They were able to communicate with higher dimensions and had the ability of time travel. The continent of Atlantis had many islands around it, and they had many Atlantean colonies in other parts of the Earth. Many different extraterrestrial races lived there hundreds of thousand years, spiritually and in harmony with the existence. Their knowledge of the cosmos was thus growing, and they learned to use cosmic energy and technology. About 700,000 years ago began the downfall of their society because many developed ego and arrogance, believing that they are gods. Most lost their spirituality and abused cosmic energy to manipulate the thoughts of others or to make genetic manipulations with humans and animals. This resulted in the stories about the ancient mermaids, minotaurs, cyclops, or sea monsters. They were obsessed by power and technology, and they started wars against the Lemurians because they saw the planet as their own property. They abused their power weapons and crystals very strongly, and about 12,000 years ago, they destroyed the entire continent of Atlantis in wars. The energy pulverized almost everything, so today there is not much left of Atlantis. Some spiritual Atlanteans were able to flee before the disaster with their spaceships. This disaster caused a pole shift in the Great Flood, as you call it today. Years later, Atlanteans and other extraterrestrials came back in other parts of the Earth, where they passed their knowledge to others. This is the reason why after the disaster, other cultures such as Egypt or Greece had suddenly knowledge of mathematics, astronomy, medicine, or architecture. They used the technology of levitation to build pyramids on many places of this planet. This abuse of power, energy, and the weapons happened at the end of the Atlantean civilization is happening today again on a smaller scale. Even today, there are people in power who want to control everything with weapons, wars, religions, drugs, genetic and mental manipulation, and greedy exploitation of Earth's resources. The rulers on Earth spend trillions of dollars on weapons and drugs rather than helping the entire planet to become a place of harmony where nobody has to starve. This all happens because most Earth humans have still not learned to live in harmony with light and love. Most Earth people laugh at light and love and worship ego, arrogance, greed and hatred. Such a course leads to self-destruction. This has happened many times in other civilizations. Only when Earth humans learn to live with spiritual light and universal love, you can live a happy, light-filled life without suffering, as it is the case on other planets. For this reason, I am practicing my entire life light work, so the main energy on Earth in the future is love and not hate, destruction and suffering. I travel with other loving people to vortex energy sites so that our light and our love becomes more powerful and thus has a greater healing effect on Earth. In November 2011, we traveled to the island of Bimini in the Bahamas. Bimini was at the west part of Atlantis, close to the vortex of Atlantis. This vortex is 35 miles or 56 kilometers east of Bimini. There used to be a crystal temple and pyramids, in which cosmic energy was used to travel in time or to communicate with higher dimensions. When Atlantis was destroyed through the abuse of this power, this temple was destroyed and the energy generated anomalies and dimensional gates in the area what is now called the Bermuda Triangle. The existence sent me and 10 other loving people to this part of the Earth to heal these old energies and to use them for the light. On Bimini there were healing temples in the time when Atlantis was still spiritual. First, we visited the places of the healing temples to strengthen our own energy before we would go to the vortex. The first day we went to the healing hall, a natural healing spring which lies in the mangrove forests. At this point, there used to be one of many crystal healing temples of Atlantis. The water here contains a strong energy and a large amount of lithium, magnesium and sulfur. Many people who visit this spring experience a mental and spiritual rejuvenation, and some experience a healing from illness or relief from vices such as smoking. If you haven't any disease, you feel an energetic charge and general well-being. The entire chain of the Bahama Islands has natural healing fountains because the energy of the Atlantean crystal temples is still working. The next day we visited the Fountain of Youth, another place where once stood a crystal healing temple. In Atlantean times, they used this site to keep themselves young by charging themselves with cosmic energy and harmonizing the yin and yang energies. What keeps you young is not the water, but the cosmic energy in the water. This is the secret why many extraterrestrials can be hundreds or thousands of years old and still look young. They use cosmic energy, the energy of the cosmic central consciousness of the existence. Many of the Atlantean temples still exist on the etheric level. The fountain that is built there today is unfortunately very dirty, so you should not drink the water from it. I took some water in my hand and touched the forehead of all participants to activate the third eye. Then we meditated to charge ourselves with the energy of the place and send healing energy to the planet. Each of the participants felt the impact of the energy.
I pictured in my mind the pink color.
Pink color, yeah.
Yeah. like a pink aura, noric color. And I saw it emerging from everyone, and spiraling, and connecting each other. And after when you put your hands on my shoulders, this increased, it has increased, and after that I felt my body balancing.
Balancing,
yes, balancing. And I was in a very, very peaceful state.
Yeah.
And I felt we were everyone connected with the same energy.
Okay. Very good.
I saw a warm energy between my eyes. Of many colors. Spiral light, especially purple. Many triangles. Pyramid,
mm-hmm.
Geometry, triangles.
Yes, yes.
And gates of light, like triangles of the golden color.
Okay.
And I was very strong.
I felt my energetic body is moving. Like a wave.
Yes.
And I felt a lot of energy while you are around me. And like when you put your hands. I don't see anything, but I felt...
You felt something, yes.
Just in my body, that's it.
Did you felt this harmonizing in the body?
Yes. In my house, I have an
unbalance.
Imbalance, yes. Yeah. And I feel some tension.
Okay. Very good. Yeah.
There was a lot of energy coming from that hole that went up and in all of you, because I saw it appear. Personally, I can feel it when it goes like that. It has come this year that every time there is energy coming into me, I can feel when it moves. And that was one time now. I also have, like you, this that it's moving here, more like the face is moving like this.
Uh-huh. The energy bodies were adjusting, you know, because we have many bodies.
Yeah.
And if the bodies, like the astral body, is not aligned with your physical body, you feel not concentrated, you know. And if it's aligned and all bodies are together, then you have the full consciousness.
Well, I just feel my new gland vibrating.
Yeah.
What I saw, I don't know if it's us or maybe Atlantis. There's a place like this, and structures like.
Buildings.
People sitting in lines, meditating.
Yeah.
I don't know. Could be us or Asian. I have this urge to touch the ground. So I touched it after touching the vegetation on the floor.
Yeah.
So I just follow in my.
The next day we took a boat and we visited the ruins of a harbor of Atlantean times. On Bimini, it is known as the Atlantis Wall and Atlantis Road. The ruins are located on the north coast of the island. Parts of the huge wall stand out from the sea. These ruins are still radiating good energy, so we went to a point where the water is only 4 meters, 13 feet deep, to swim and dive to the bottom. These ruins were part of a city and are more than 800,000 years old. They are among the few who remained left after the destruction of Atlantis, because this city was at the edge of Atlantis. Even if they are old and the erosion of the stone blocks is strong, you can still see the rectangular shape of the blocks. next day we went to the beach next to the ruins to recharge our energy and make light work. We charged from the energy of the sun, the energy of the island, the energy of the earth, the energy of the water and the salt crystals. By connecting with the energy of the earth and the sun, your aura becomes powerful and luminous. If you make this barefoot, you can feel the energy flow between the feet and the earth. If you bathe in the sea, you literally bathe in light energy. This is keeping your body healthy, because the energy of the body is in tune with the spiritual light of the source. If you are not living near the sea, you can go in a forest and hug a tree. In a forest, you can bathe in cosmic energy too, if the forest is healthy. Trees are antennas for cosmic energy. You get the highest and most lightful energy when you do it with joy, fun and love. With this powerful light and love energy, you are an energy vortex and you are ready to do light work. You send all the joy and the love that you feel to the entire planet, to all people, to all animals, to all plants. You heal with that the earth from all negative energies, because as I said already in my other videos, everything is connected energetically in the cosmos. If you want to change lower frequencies, you must use a higher energy. And the highest energy is the energy of love. The energy of love is the energy of the existence, the creation, the source. And you can use the spiritual energy to create a positive life. With the power of love, you can cure diseases and addictions, eliminate hate, violence and fear, and increase awareness. You can send the energy of love even to the rulers of this planet, so that their heart opens and they change their behavior. If they would feel their heart, they would feel compassion and they would use their money and power for the good of all, instead of spending it on weapons and control systems. Money is a form of energy on this planet and it should be used spiritually to help other people. With the energy of love, you can transform the Earth society into a society of peace and joy, just like it is already the case on other planets. The next day we hiked to the most northern part of the island, where the energy is strongest. Here too we charge ourselves with the energy of love and then radiate the energy around the planet. In addition, I made also private sessions to help with any personal issues. Every night we went to the beach where many orbs visited us. All the past days we charged our energy with light and love, so the next day we were ready to visit the Atlantis vortex. The Atlantis vortex is located 35 miles or 56 kilometers east of Bimini in the Bermuda Triangle. With a boat you need 3 hours to get there. On a boat was full of love and joy. This keeps the spiritual energy at the highest level. came closer and closer to the vortex, we could feel the change in energy. The electromagnetic energy of this vortex made our physical compass restless, and our digital compass was not working anymore. Even the compass of the boat turned out.
My compass doesn't work anymore.
Really?
It's never happened before. It does not spin. It no longer points north.
But do you know where we are?
Yes. Yes, GPS still works. The compass doesn't work.
At this place was the strongest power center of Atlantis. It was a crystal temple in which cosmic energy was used to travel in time and communicate with higher dimensions. This temple is still there in the etheric dimensions, and spiritual masters in the higher dimensions are still using this energy. When we arrived, we meditated, and together with light beings and spiritual masters, we did light work and sent healing energy to the planet. You can watch our entire meditation from Atlantis Bimini Vortex in my next film, where you can connect energetically with it and participate with the light work. After the meditation, we went swimming in the vortex. The water here is only 2 meters, 6 feet deep, although it is located in the sea. The reason for that is because in Atlantean times, the Bahama Islands used to be higher, and therefore it was one big island. Later, many parts of the Bahamas sank a few meters, and only a few parts are over the sea level.
Thank you.
After 1 hour energy bathing in the Bermuda Triangle, we were ready to drive back to Bimini. On the ride back, we had a surprise. First, we saw an etheric spaceship disguised as a cloud.
From the middle, see in the middle, it is like a solid ball, and around it has.
This spacecraft manifested around it the shape of a dolphin. With that sign, my space brothers announced that soon some dolphins will come to give thanks to our network. 1 hour later, 3 dolphins came and were swimming in front of our boat. Even from this distance, you can feel the love energy of dolphins. They were happy that we have sent spiritual light on the planet. Dolphins are highly spiritual extraterrestrials incarnated from Sirius B. Sirius B is a water planet in a higher frequency, which is why they have chosen to live on Earth in the ocean as dolphins and whales. In a whale, you can find a group consciousness, because many souls from Sirius B are incarnating together in a whale. They can also incarnate in a human form or live in etheric form. One can say that whales are like organic spaceships, where you can find sometimes teams of up to 100 people in a group consciousness together. That is why whales are big mobile vortex portals. We Pleiadians work together with dolphins and whales to help Earth in the process of transformation of consciousness. When dolphins jump and trill, they create a happy vortex energy, and this energy is amplified in the group. If you are close to them, you can feel the powerful healing energy of love. Even by watching this film, it is possible to get their energy. In the ocean, there are many natural energy vortexes and portals, and dolphins influenced and reinforced these energies. Earth people must learn to recognize the spiritual masters who are here to help everybody. The barbaric killing and eating of whales and dolphins must stop. As I said already in my other movies, killing is producing the worst negative karma. And then it is not by accident when natural disasters happen in order to clean this negative energy. Dolphins and whales have the same soul energy as humans, even if they live in another physical body. They have a higher awareness than Earth people and want to help people to achieve a higher consciousness too. Earth humans should protect them and learn from them. The meaning of life is to have spiritual, universal love in the heart and to live in harmony and in tune with the existence, in tune with the light from the source of all sources. Universal love is the most important that Earth humans need to learn. You live many lives on many different planets in the lower dimensions in order to learn this. If you have mastered that, you can also incarnate in higher dimensions, where one lives a life full of light without pain or sorrow. This is not a belief system. That are universal facts about the functioning of life. Many souls who have lived already on the higher dimensions incarnate on Earth to make the energy of universal love accessible to all Earth humans. People with universal love in their heart are light workers because they use the love of the existence to create a loving planet. Light workers have nothing to do with religion, sects of planet Earth. Love is the essence of the existence and has nothing to do with religion, sex or planet Earth, who have deprived, tortured and killed millions of Earth humans. Religions on Earth are dangerous sects with fanatical followers who are attacking loving lightworkers, just as they did with the lightworker Jesus. Religions and hate are inventions that you can find only on unconscious, low-developed planets and are the cause of many wars. On higher developed planets, you live aware and in accordance with the central cosmic consciousness in harmony with love. Universal love is no religion or belief system and creates peace and harmony. Love is the power and the essence of the spiritual light. It is very important that many people use the energy of universal love to remove all negativity on planet Earth. There are too many negative humans on Earth who focus more on technology, power, religion, greed and hatred instead on the development of the heart. Technology and power without love and wisdom is very dangerous because it is misused against Earth, humanity and nature, and that leads to self-destruction. This planet could be a place of love and joy when all people had the power of love in their hearts. That would eliminate all the negativities on this planet. Let us remove violence, hatred, envy, greed and oppression forever from this planet. I encourage all Earth humans to walk the path of light and be in tune with the existence. In all of my videos I explain how to do it. May the light of the existence enlighten your spirit. Be a channel and vortex for the love of the existence. May your love reach everybody. Universal love is the solution for everything.